Today we will be discussing some of the recent news surrounding NEO stock. Make sure to give us a like and subscribe to the channel for more stock updates like today. Also, Webull is giving 2 free stocks, valued all the way up to $1,600, only after you deposit $100 on the platform. Use the link down in the description to get your 2 free stocks, and now let's begin with our video. NEO enjoyed a stock rally that began in June. After months of worrying about its solvency, the company reported strong sales in China. The end of the lockdown in the country led to a rebound in revenue. By September, NEO posted a 133.2% year-over-year increase in vehicle deliveries. For the 3 months ended September, deliveries grew by an impressive 154.3%, to 12,206 vehicles. NEO's battery leasing offering will likely drive quarterly sales higher. The two EV models target an array of customer types. The ES6 is a 5-seater premium SUV, while the EC6 is a coupe SUV that it launched in July. And because the EC6 is available in 3 trims, Sporty, Performance, and Signature, Chinese customers have plenty of choices. The 7-seater ES8, at $67,783, is half the price of Tesla's Model X. NEO has the advantage over Tesla with this price difference. NEO's Pilot performs better than Tesla's autonomous driving. As Chinese customers compare NEO to Tesla, they will find that NEO's assisted driving solution is better suited for Chinese traffic conditions. NEO CEO William Li said the company test drove more than 300,000 kilometers across 30 major cities. With the map data collected, NEO's self-driving EVs will fare better than Tesla's autopilot. In August, NEO hired Ren Shexing, a computer vision expert and the co-founder of Momenta, a startup in the self-driving field. NEO will continue to improve their technology and perfect it for the roads in China. The electric car has been around since 1880, but this is the only time it has a chance at success. The EV push is definitely gaining strength. The difference is tangible, even since last year. There are only a few providers of EVs and a slew of others coming online. This means that the potential upside for NEO is huge. Having competition is not a problem, in fact, it is an asset. The more of them there are, the more mainstream EVs will become. Older car companies will realize that EV is the future for vehicles, and they will need to jump on this trend. Car companies like GM haven't actually their electric vehicles yet. Many companies are behind the curve, and companies like Tesla and NEO have the advantage over traditional car companies. When this technology becomes more mainstream, they will be behind the curve, and EV companies will be taking up the market share. In the short term, it is hard to predict what will happen with NEO stock, but for the long term, the future for NEO is bright. The China's State Council estimated sales of new energy vehicles, which include battery electric, plug-in hybrid and hydrogen fuel cell vehicles, to account for 20% of overall new car sales by 2025 in China, which is currently the largest EV market from just 5% now. EV technology isn't going anywhere, and Tesla opened the door for this. We can expect more growth for this industry in China with their aggressive policies, and in other countries with progressive green policies. Expansion into Europe is going to be a big step for NEO in 2021, but I think that during that time NEO will solidify their business in China and continue to expand their production capacity and exceed our expectations for the stock. Make sure to give us a like and subscribe to the channel for more stock updates like today. Also, Webull is giving 2 free stocks, valued all the way up to $1,600, only after you deposit $100 on the platform. Use the link down in the description to get your 2 free stocks, and we will see you in the next video.